Here's a topic from a recent episode of The Insiders.
This was a horrific weekend for the Kansas State basketball staff in the portal. They had two main guys that they had been pursuing for quite a while, and they offered. So, Ryan Gilbert, just give us a recap of what happened in the portal as people kind of load up their questions here, hopefully. And what does this mean for K-State hoops?
Well, yeah. I mean, you go back to a few weeks ago and you saw the signs all throughout Manhattan, you know, welcome home, Clifford, welcome home to battle as well. And so that those visits were a couple of weeks back now. But I think the bigger one that maybe hurts is battle. I know that Cliff going to Bama, that obviously stings, but that was kind of a wild recruitment. I'm not sure that many schools felt confident up until that very end, right? K-State liked its chances. I think the visit went well, from our understanding, but losing out on Clifford was what it was. Now, battle, that's the one that hurts. And
yeah,
our understanding, K-State felt really, really good about that one after the visit. And I don't think this staff really envisioned battle going anywhere else. I think that they thought they had locked him down. And then you see him go out and visit Gonzaga. Ultimately, that's where he chooses. And so that's the frustrating one. But you intertwine it when they commit on the same day. It's tough. And the overall, I think, frustrating part for fans is you look at what K-State had last year with Day-Day Ames and RJ Jones and Colbert, Kaluma. These guys could be on this roster if the staff wasn't going out and recruiting so many players in the portal, right? And they're missing out on those players. And so you're in a worse spot than you were to begin with. And so I'm sure we can dive into all of that, but not a good Sunday, not a good Cinco de Mayo for K-State fans following basketball recruiting. They go 0-2. Battle hurts a lot more than Clifford, in my opinion, but they both sting. But I know that this staff felt really confident after that battle visit. I know NIL has been a huge topic of discussion, especially with the rumors about with Cliff going to Bama, and he was, you know, rumored to have been offered $2 million, right? There's no way that could have been Kansas State. There's no way that much money would be thrown at one player. And so I don't think the NIL is really a huge issue here. I know that's being thrown around a lot, but K-State's competitive in this market. There's schools out there that can compete that don't necessarily have the biggest NIL budgets, and they're still getting those guys. So it's something else. What exactly is it? I'm sure you guys could provide some insight on that as well, but nobody knows, but something's going on, obviously.
Brian, if it's not broke, don't fix it, but this is broke. Something's not working.
No, definitely not working. Look, if you're going to live in the portal, then you got to win. It's just that simple. And Gills, you're right. You know, some of the guys that left, the only pushback that I would have is, did we replace those guys with maybe better guys or at least equal to their talent? Maybe we did. Maybe we didn't. K-State just doesn't have any bigs right now. I mean, look, that's the problem. I mean, you got to have guys that can go rebound the basketball, or a guy you can throw it in inside and go score, and they got to be able to get those guys. But if you're going to live in the portal, you got to win.